Hello everyone, welcome back to Wellness Zone. Today I'm going to explain what a liver function test, LFT, is, why you might need one, and how to interpret the results. Your liver is one of the most important organs in your body, as it performs hundreds of vital functions, such as filtering toxins, producing bile, and regulating blood sugar. However, your liver can also be affected by various diseases and conditions, such as hepatitis, cirrhosis, fatty liver, and cancer. That's why it's important to check your liver health regularly, and one of the ways to do that is by taking a liver function test. So, what is a liver function test? A liver function test is a blood test that measures the levels of certain enzymes, proteins, and substances in your blood that are related to your liver function. By checking these levels, your doctor can assess how well your liver is working. And if there are any signs of liver damage or disease, a liver function test can also help diagnose the cause of your symptoms, such as jaundice, abdominal pain, or fatigue, and monitor the effects of treatment or medication on your liver. There are several components of a liver function test, and each one can provide different information about your liver health. Here are some of the most common ones. Number 1, alanine aminotransferase, ALT, and aspartate aminotransferase, AST. ALT is also referred to as SGPT, and AST is also referred to as SGOT. ALT and AST are enzymes that are mainly found in your liver cells, and they help break down proteins and amino acids. When your liver cells are damaged or inflamed, these enzymes leak into your bloodstream and their levels increase. High levels of ALT and AST can indicate liver injury due to various causes, such as viral or alcoholic hepatitis, liver cirrhosis, drug overdose, or liver cancer. The normal range of ALT or SGPT is 7 to 56 units per liter, and the normal range of AST or SGOT is 5 to 40 units per liter. Elevated levels of AST and ALT may signify the level of liver damage or liver inflammation in a person. Number 2, alkaline phosphatase, ALP. ALP is an enzyme that is found in your liver and bone, and it helps break down proteins and phosphates. The normal range of ALP is 30 to 140 international units per liter. A high ALP level does not necessarily reflect liver damage or inflammation. However, high levels of ALP occurs when there is a blockage of flow in the biliary tract, or a buildup of pressure in the liver, often caused by a gallstone or scarring in the bile ducts. High levels of ALP can also indicate bone disease, such as osteoporosis, Paget's disease, or bone cancer. Number 3, gamma-glutamyl transferase, GGT. GGT is an enzyme that is found in your liver and bile ducts, and it helps transport amino acids and glutathione. GGT is an important parameter in identifying liver damage or liver inflammation. High levels of GGT can indicate liver damage due to alcohol abuse, as alcohol can increase the production of this enzyme. The normal range of GGT is 0 to 50 international units per liter. High levels of GGT can also indicate liver damage due to other causes, such as viral or autoimmune hepatitis, liver cirrhosis, or liver cancer. Number 4, bilirubin. Bilirubin is a yellow pigment that is produced when your red blood cells break down. Bilirubin is normally transported by your blood to your liver, where it is converted into a water-soluble form and excreted in your bile. High levels of bilirubin can indicate liver damage or disease, as your liver may not be able to process or eliminate it properly. High levels of bilirubin can cause your skin and eyes to turn yellow, a condition known as jaundice. The normal range of bilirubin is 3 to 17 micromoles per liter. High levels of bilirubin can also indicate hemolytic anemia, a condition where your red blood cells are destroyed faster than they are produced. Number 5, albumin and total protein. Albumin is one of the main proteins that is produced by your liver, and it helps maintain the fluid balance in your blood and tissues. Total protein is the sum of all the proteins in your blood, including albumin and other proteins that are produced by your liver or other organs. Low levels of albumin and total protein can indicate liver damage or disease, as your liver may not be able to produce enough protein. The normal range of albumin is 35 to 54 grams per liter, or 3.5 to 5.4 grams per deciliter. And the normal range of total protein is 60 to 80 grams per liter, or 6.0 to 8.0 grams per deciliter. Low levels of albumin and total protein can also indicate malnutrition, kidney disease, or inflammation. These are some of the most common components of a liver function test, but there may be other tests that your doctor may order, depending on your symptoms and medical history. For example, your doctor may also check the levels of ammonia, lactate dehydrogenase, prothrombin time, or alpha-fetoprotein, which can provide more information about your liver function and health. Now you may be wondering, how do you prepare for a liver function test, and what do the results mean? Well, here are some tips and guidelines to help you understand your liver function test better. Firstly, how to prepare for a liver function test? A liver function test is a simple blood test that can be done at a clinic or a laboratory. To prepare for the test, you may need to fast for 8 to 12 hours before the test, as some foods and drinks can affect the results. You may also need to avoid certain medications, supplements, or alcohol, as they can also interfere with the test. Your doctor will give you specific instructions on how to prepare for the test, and you should follow them carefully. The test itself will only take a few minutes, and you will only feel a slight pinch when the needle is inserted into your vein. The blood sample will then be sent to a laboratory for analysis, and you will get your results in a few days. How to interpret the results of a liver function test? The results of a liver function test will show the levels of the different components that were measured in your blood. Your doctor will compare these levels to the normal ranges and see if there are any abnormalities or deviations. If your levels are within the normal ranges, it means that your liver is functioning well and there is no sign of liver damage or disease. However, if your levels are higher or lower than the normal ranges, it means that there may be some problem with your liver and further investigation is needed. Your doctor will explain what your results mean and what the possible causes and implications are. Your doctor may also order more tests, such as imaging tests, biopsy, or genetic tests, to confirm the diagnosis and determine the best treatment plan for you. These are some of the tips and guidelines on how to prepare for and interpret the results of a liver function test. A liver function test is a useful tool to check your liver health and to diagnose and monitor liver conditions. However, it is not the only tool, and it is not always conclusive. Therefore, you should always consult your doctor for a comprehensive evaluation and advice, and follow their recommendations for treatment and prevention. Also, if you want to know how to reverse fatty liver, and what are best foods and supplements to recover your liver from any disease, be sure to check out other videos in our channel. Thank you for watching this video, and I hope you learned something new today. If you did, please give this video a thumbs up and leave a comment below. I would love to hear from you and answer any questions you may have. Also, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon to get notified of my new videos.